In this video, we're going to review long division of polynomials. So in this particular example, I have this rational function t cubed minus 2 over t plus 1. Now long division is going to apply in cases where we have what's called an improper rational function. And what that means is that the degree of the numerator is either greater than or equal to the degree of the denominator. So in this case, the degree of my numerator is 3, and the degree of my denominator is 1. So long division then is a way I could rewrite this rational function. So I'm going to assume that you've seen this before, and this is just going to be a review. So let's review how we would divide t cubed minus 2 by t plus 1. Okay, so the general way we set this up is like this. T cubed minus 2 is going to go under my division sign, and then t plus 1 is out here. Now in this case, I'm actually going to rewrite this just a little bit. And this is just going to help us with keeping our work organized. So I'm going to write this as t cubed minus 0 t squared, or I can write plus 0 t squared, plus 0 t minus 2. And this will make more sense in just a second why this is helpful. But once again, this is just going to help us keep our work organized. But I still just have my t cubed minus 2. Okay, so how does this process of long division work? Well, what I'm going to be doing to start out with is I'm going to be looking at this first term under the division sign and this first term outside the division sign. And I'm going to ask myself, how many times does t go into t cubed? Or perhaps a more helpful question would be, t times what equals t cubed? So the answer in this case is t squared, right? T times t squared gives me t cubed. So then I'm going to put a t squared on top here. Okay, so then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this term that I just came up with, this t squared, and I'm going to multiply it by this expression outside the division sign. So I'm going to multiply t squared by t plus 1, and I'm going to write it down here. So t squared times t plus 1 is t cubed plus t squared if I distribute. And I'm going to be subtracting that quantity. So it's helpful if you put it in parentheses and then put a subtraction sign out front. Okay, so this is why I put these extra terms in here, so that I could space this nicely, line this up nicely. So now what I have is t cubed minus t cubed. Now if you did this correctly, those first terms should always cancel to 0. And then I have 0 minus t squared. So that gives me minus t squared overall. And then I can actually go ahead and bring down my other terms. So from here, I'm going to keep repeating the same process. But I'm going to be looking now at this new line. So here, negative t squared plus 0t minus 2. And once again, this t plus 1 that's outside the division sign. So here, I'm going to be asking myself, how many times does t go into negative t squared? Or what do I need to multiply by to get negative t squared? So here the answer to that question is negative t, right? T times negative t gives me negative t squared. Now once again, I'm going to take this term I just came up with, negative t, and multiply it by t plus 1 and write my result down here. So that, if I distribute, would give me negative t squared minus t. And I'm going to subtract that entire quantity. Okay, so I've got t squared minus negative t squared. So those cancel. And then I've got 0 minus negative t. So that's a positive t overall. Just make sure you're careful of your signs here. Bring down my 2. Okay, so now I ask myself, how many times does t go into t? Well, that's just 1. So I get a plus 1 up here. And then I do 1 times t plus 1, which just gives me, of course, t plus 1. Subtract that quantity. T minus t is 0, negative 2 minus 1 is negative 3. Now, here's where I'm done for this particular problem, because at this point, t does not go into negative 3. So negative 3 would be what we call our remainder. Okay, so then the way we would write our answer is this division, or this rational function, is equivalent to t squared minus t plus 1. Okay, so what I have on top here, my result. And then I need to make sure to include the remainder. And the way I write the remainder is minus 3 and then over what's outside the division sign here. So over t plus 1 in this case. And this is my result of my long division problem.